Good morning, everybody. I'm Ann Rossley. I'm here with my friend and colleague, Kyle Harvey. We're with Baird Warner. We sell real estate in downtown Chicago, and we love to come together every week to talk with you about what's going on in the real estate market. Hey, Kyle.
Good morning.
You couldn't wait to start the show today. You're so excited about what we have going on. You can hardly wait.
I can hardly wait because it's a throwback. And I love to revisit my youth. And so some of this is going to be revisiting our youth.
Yes. If you looked at the teaser for our show, we're going to talk about films in Chicago. But we've got some other stuff to do first. We're going to talk about stats. We're going to also show you one listing that's coming on the market. And then we're going to maybe get to a beautiful home. We've got all kinds of good stuff. We can hardly stand it. So let me first go to stats and we'll... go from there. All right. So stats. I did something different this week. You know,
get rid of our names.
Okay. Will do. Sorry, everybody.
No. We do this every week. This is our little
show. I know. Every week I can't get my act together. Okay. So what I did this week is I didn't do the ups and downs and the month supply and all that. You've heard me talk about that for the last 3 weeks. New statistics come out in about 3 days. So we're going to talk now about single family homes and condos and median sales price by neighborhood.
Wow.
So let's start first with the Loop. There are no single family homes in the Loop, so I can't give you a median sales price. The South Loop. We have a few single family homes in the South Loop. Median sales price, $1.2 million. It's up 14% versus previous year. The Near West Side, with a median sales price of $606,000, is up 21%. This is the biggest increase in the city. Oh, no, it's not. Lincoln Park is even higher. But, okay, second closest, highest. Still, $606,000 to be this close to the city in a single-family home?
Yes.
That's pretty incredible. I would target this area.
It also means that people are moving there, that it's desired. It's a great area.
Absolutely. So if you're looking for a hot single family home area, don't want to pay a lot, West Loop could be your place. All right. Near North Side, that includes.
Wow. Loop.
Yeah. Up 30%. I hadn't recognized that. And that is a real number. But, you know, there aren't as many homes on the Near North Side, but you've got the $3 to $6 million homes in the Gold Coast. So a couple of those going under contract could totally skew this. 1,750,000. Wow. Interesting. There must've been a couple that sold because this is just the August month, people. This is not like,
yeah,
whatever. Okay. Let's go up to Lincoln Park. That is kind of the single family neighborhood of high regard. 1,710,000. It's up 22% year over year. Look at these single family home prices. Up. Really? I'm surprised that Westtown at 965 is only up 2.7%, but that's perhaps because they've seen steady growth over the last several months. So that's another really good opportunity for a single family home close to the city. Don't you think?
I do.
All right.
Look at that.
West
Logan up, Square, Uptown, yeah.
Yeah. Logan Square up 7.5%. And again, there are lots of condos there. There are lots of two flats there. It's a good single family opportunity. Lakeview, 1,362,000. That's kind of where the prices have been, you know, steady, up 3.7%. And again, remember, people, this is August of this year versus August of last year, just coming out of COVID. So
I think August of last year had more transactions. So, and this was a much more normal August. So yes. I think the fact that there's growth, even though it's a slightly slower in terms of transactions, is pretty great.
Yeah, absolutely. I totally agree with you. And this is, I mean, granted it's 1 month, but it's been increasing over the last year for sure. North yeah. Center, 1,160,000, not a surprise. You've got lots of great single family homes there, new construction single family homes over the last 5 years, and lots of elementary school neighborhoods that people are moving into. So that's a very strong, that includes Roscoe Village. All right, Avondale, one of the hot neighborhoods. You can get a single family home for a median sales price of $560,000. That's up 8.2%. Irving Park, which includes Old Irving and some of these, you know, older, beautiful, historic neighborhoods, $595,000. Now, this is parts of Irving Park are along the Metra and the Blue Line. So that's very okay for a commuter line, you know, close
that's
to
great.
The Kennedy there. So, yeah, you're in good shape. Let's come back to Uptown. This one surprised me. If you're a single family home in Uptown, the price is $960 on average. And you're going to see in a minute, the condominium prices are very low here, comparatively speaking. So it's an interesting neighborhood. Edgewater, which includes Lakewood, Balmoral, Bowmanville, part of East Ravenswood, $828.
That's nice growth.
Up 12.4%. Yeah. Look at Lincoln Square. It's almost up 20% at $875.
That is such a hot neighborhood. It's been a hot neighborhood for years.
It has, but you know, back in like 2008, 9, 10, it kind of dipped down.
Did it? Okay.
Yeah, it dipped down a little bit then, but yeah, it's roaring back. Yeah. And the same with Albany Park, which includes Ravenswood Manor and some of those areas, 491, up 10%.
Yep.
So thought that was very interesting. Now let's look at condos. And let's start at the south again. Okay. Loop, median sales price in the Loop, 378, up 17.5%. That is a skewed number, as Kyle and I have talked about, because of the St. Regis closings. It's giving us a lot more closings to bring up the median sales price.
But it also reflects how the sales were so down during COVID. People reduced their prices. And now they're getting better prices. Absolutely, St. Regis. But I think things are starting to close. And so prices are starting to go up again.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you're right.
All right. South Loop is steady at 365. The Lower West Side, 387.5. And the Near West Side, 365 is up 4%. All right. Near North, which includes Streeterville, River North, Gold Coast. Median sales price of $397.5. It's down 1.9%. We haven't seen big new construction in the last 6 months, really. In, you know, because like One Bennett's basically closed. You've got
One Chicago is coming up. I think they're starting to have closings. I've started to see that as closings.
All right, down 1.9 doesn't scare me a lot. I think it's just an anomaly.
Yeah.
Same with Westtown at 485, down 2%. It just could be that they're selling a lot of the lower price stuff right now. Mm-hmm. You know, I consider that pretty, you know, and Lincoln Park 472.5.
Well, remember, to your point, as one of the things that I have noticed and we've talked about on this show is there is nothing that sells faster than Sandburg Village, which is selling in the high 100,000s to the low 300,000s, which would drag down the sales price, the average sales price.
Right. There are a lot of units over there. Yeah.
A lot of units, but they turn over in days. So those things are because first-time homebuyers, downsizers, right. Everyone is going into Sandburg Village. Amazing.
Very good point. Yeah. So yeah, I mean, look at the prices. I mean, $397.5 to be in the Near North, but you've got to pay $485 to be in Westtown. I mean, interesting. Okay.
I think they're also different sizes. I think the Wicker Park and Westtown will have more two bedrooms, whereas the Near North side is also going to have a lot of one bedrooms, which is going to drop the price.
Yes, that's right. Logan Square, 410, up 2.2%. Logan Square has been hot over the last 2 years. And 410 is really a big price for that neighborhood. It's really commanding higher prices these days. Lincoln Park 472.5, Lakeview 375. Again, that's down 1.3, but I don't think that's indicative of a long-term trend.
No.
North Center doesn't have as many condos. It's like Westtown at 448. It's got more of those three-unit buildings or the larger two bedrooms. Avondale 363 up 6.2, because again, that's a hot, hot area. Irving Park 226. Lincoln Square is 320, up 3.2. Okay, so here's the thing. You're under 300,000 for a condo in Uptown, but you have to pay over 960 for a single family home. It's a bigger disparity. And I think that's in part due to some of the high rises along the lakefront.
I think you're right.
And the same is true for sure for Edgewater, because Edgewater actually has the most housing units of any community in the city. That's because of all of these high rises along Sheridan Road here.
It's either high rises or low rises. There's nothing sort of in between. There's no, you know, eight story
mid-rise kind of, yeah.
Yeah, it's either three stories, four stories, or 25.
Yeah. And it's up, though. Condominium sales prices are up, which is a big deal for being in that area. So
yeah,
that's it. That's all I have to say about stats this week.
Well, we also got some news this morning. Cranes is reporting that they're planning to put a metro stop in Fulton Market for all the people commuting from the suburbs to all the headquarters and other offices that are coming into the Fulton Market area. But think about that. As if Fulton Market's area needs any more reasons for people to buy or want to buy those great condos.
That area has
there.
Been hot, hot, hot. I had dinner there last week, and you know, I go in and out of there regularly, but I'm not always eating dinner. I was shocked by just how much is going on and how much is going on north of Randolph Street. You know, south of Randolph in the West Loop has always been big, but when you look at Fulton, Hubbard, Grand, those streets are just crazy. And like you said, it's not like they need, you know, another reason to be, you know, buying in that neighborhood. Tell me, did they say exactly where they're going to put the metro?
No, it's too new. It's just breaking news. I think we'll get more information. If Cranes picked it up, there'll be more information probably later today, maybe an announcement from the MTA, but or whatever we call it. Metro stop.
RTA. Yeah, these things tend to take a while because they've been talking about putting in a metro stop up in Edgewater by Ashland, where Ashland and Peterson and Ridge come together.
Really?
It's been in the works for like 10 years, but it's getting closer. So I don't know where they are, but.
You know, other cities have used light rail.
Yeah.
And that might be something because it's cheaper to lay. But you need a wide street, and Ashland would be sort of the wide street that you could do light rail on. But anyway, cool. All righty. So let's get to the meat of the show.
Okay. So everybody, if you saw, I'm going to share this with you. If you saw our, like, what do you call it? Our teaser, which said it's about film in Chicago. But
yes. This
you may recognize as the Wilmette home from Ferris Bueller. We are not going to talk about that, nor are we going to talk about Home Alone, which was this house.
Doesn't that look so dated now? Go back to that.
Yeah.
Go back to the Home Alone house. Doesn't that look so dated? I wonder what it looks like today.
The same.
You
it looks the same today. Yes, it does.
Ugh.
Yes, it does. And this is the 16 Candles house. I don't know if you remember
that. Candles.
You know, I am such a big John Hughes fan. And, you know, bless his heart, he did so many wonderful movies in Chicago. But we're going to talk about some other stuff.
Yeah.
Like,
okay.
Time for you to share.
Okay, so I got to put up my share screen.
Yeah,
share.
Yeah.
You got to unshare.
No, you just go ahead and put yours up and then I'll.
All right. Okay, share. Hold on.
There you go. Your Google's up. There you go. So, everybody, here's the deal. We're going to show you some great films. The first one is, if you haven't seen it before, The Hunter with Steve McQueen. That was a great Chicago film. It's not showing.
Did that not?
That didn't share.
Okay, well, no, no, no. It's just, hold on. Hold on. All righty, we're going to, oopsie. See, now you're doing it. Unshare, stop share. All right, hold on. Live, whatchamacallit?
Yeah, this is what happens when you're live. You get to see all the good, the bad, and the ugly.
Share a different share. I'm going to share this screen, people, and just ignore all the other gobbledygook.
You're not going to share video?
Yeah. No, I don't know if I can share video because I have to have a clip. Oopsie, I forgot to share window. So now we're going to do the window. Okay, so let's just see if I can make the damn thing.
Stay with us, everybody. This is us, going people. To be worth it.
Stay with us. So okay. Worth it. So here we are trying it again. Is sharing a window? Stop share. There we go.
Okay, I've got Google again.
I know you do have Google, but I'm going to try and throw it over there as quickly as I can. So hold on. Let me do it like this. Let me do this again.
There we go. Yes, make it large screen. There it goes. There's going into the Chicago River.
Look at that beautiful building.
Yes.
So much. Oh, my office gosh. Is not there. I used to work at
it's old Chicago.
That's
I don't remember what year that was. Well done.
Okay, hold on.
Love it.
All right, there we go. There's that one. Okay.
Okay, so that was The Hunter, Steve McQueen, Chicago River.
Okay.
Are you ready for Chucky and Child's Play?
Oh,
no, that's mine to share, isn't it?
Yeah, you got to share that one. I don't have that one.
Okay, so 2800 Brewster, this is a really cool building. This building, the inside, well, I'll show you.
I have it too. I have it up on mine.
Oh, you show then.
Then show, give me the, there we go.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Give me some big pictures. So I don't watch scary movies, but I guess the babysitter jumps out of the window of the Brewster. This is 2800 North Pine Grove. And you can live in this building.
It's so that's on the corner of
Pine Grove and Diversity. Right? Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's awesome. It's this beautiful limestone. Look at the interior.
Doesn't that look spooky?
That's the elevator is spectacular in this thing. And there's a one bedroom for sale. Look at you even got green views. There's a one bedroom for sale right now for $219,000. That's what she's showing.
Isn't
so
that
you could live.
Cute.
Yeah, you can live where Chucky lived. I don't even know the plot of the movie. Do you know the plot? Did you ever watch it?
I think a doll comes alive and attacks people and he's just evil. Okay. I'm going to say that I believe that I saw it.
Yeah.
I have no recollection further. Okay, next.
That's so freaking awesome, isn't it?
Yes.
Oh my God.
What are we doing next?
Okay, let's do my favorite, Only the Lonely. Oh, wait, that's not Only the Lonely.
This is Only the Lonely.
Oh, it is Only the Lonely. Yeah, it is. Okay. So, Only the Lonely.
You didn't see this, people starting.
Oh, are you ready to start?
Yeah.
You can't really hear this. So, we're not even going to try. But look at this really cool old Chicago interior, right? So, they live in a two flat in this show. And he lives upstairs, mom lives downstairs, and it's the typical boy needs to grow up and move out. And he falls in love with Ally Sheedy, who's a mortician. But they're always, did you know they tore these homes down? These homes were on Roscoe, and I used to take my kids to school at Hawthorne. And I would drive by these homes, and it would cheer me up every day. These homes are now those three flat things. It makes me sad. But I love Maria O'Hara.
Look at the pink subway tile in that kitchen.
Oh my God. It's so great. And Anthony Quinn is in this, and he lives next door, and he tends his garden, and it's the old Chicago houses. There's a scene in this movie where he goes in a fire truck to propose to Ally Sheedy, who lives over the funeral home, because she's the mortician. And it is one of those old Italian or Polish funeral homes, you know, that are two stories where they really did live above. So crazy about that.
Well, I wonder if it was the funeral there, because there are a whole bunch of funeral homes on Lincoln Avenue, those really thick brick.
Yes, that's exactly what it is. Yes, and you've seen the movie, so you know what I'm talking about. Huh. Here's Emmett's. This is the pub where the action takes place. There are a lot of things that occur in this, and this is also at the corner of Roscoe and Clark in Lakeview. So they call it something else in the movie, but that's basically it. So,
alrighty.
Anyway, what else? So that's that one. Which one do you want to do next?
Well, let's do Twin Anchors and Old Town, only because the other one is Nothing in Common is also Marina City. We, you know, Marina City is great.
Oh, well, it is that, but it's one other. So, okay.
Oh, so, is it one other too?
Yeah, but you pull it up.
Wait. Which ones do we want? Oh, the pool? Oh, that's the only. Which one am I doing?
Yeah, Nothing in Common. Nothing in Common is good. Nothing in Common is young Tom Hanks with Jackie Gleason. And part of it takes place in the pool at Outer Drive East, 400 East Randolph. Part of it, too, is in Marina City in the garage.
Oh, there it is. You're right.
There are several scenes that take place in the pool. That geodesic, if you've been at New East Side, which is north of Millennium Park, south of the Chicago River, it's the oldest building over
is
there.
Is that Tuesday Well?
Yeah.
I forget
that. Awesome. And then here's Tom Hanks with Celia Ward.
Oh my God! In front of the
the flamingo. Yeah, yeah. And look at this. This has to be on State Street, right?
This is right by me.
Yeah. Love it. Look at him. Oh my gosh! Are we dating ourselves, Kyle?
We're so dating ourselves, people. Maybe I'll mute it just because it's so ridiculous. Oh
look
my God.
Boy. I've always thought she's beautiful.
This
okay,
used
so
to be a
that.
Really good restaurant, and it's gone away, and now it's torn down. It's going to be town. It's going to be apartments.
I know.
Oh, all right. I'm stopping sharing.
Okay. But back to here, that's what the pool looks like without the people doing exercises. You know, that was also the beginning of Jane Fonda when that they were stretching in there. I thought that was pretty funny.
This pool still looks like this.
Yeah, it does. It's awesome.
Awesome.
All right, now I'm going to have to find. Well, you do yours next.
My what? Oh, yes. Hold on.
This is another one of my favorites.
Which one?
The one you're about to show.
What am I about to show?
Return to Me.
Oh, Return to Me. Oh, is that about the, hold on. I stopped sharing, so I got to share again. Hold on. Share screen. All right. Okay, hold on. Share. Okay, here comes Return to Me. And this doesn't give us so much of a view. But it's such an, for God's sake, go over here. Did it come up over there or is it not coming up over there? Can you see it?
I see Google.
Hold on. We got to toss it in. There we go. Do you see it?
Yes.
We're undoing the mute.
A bottle of water.
Sure. Anyone else?
May I have a wine in this place?
Twin Anchors.
Do we know each other?
I think so.
So Mini Driver, David Duchovny.
Oh, no, I think I remember.
And
that.
Robert Loggia, like all these old Italian men.
Oh,
it's not
God.
The,
love,
it's
love,
not
love,
the.
Love, water. I don't want
rib
Swiss water. Swiss water once. Do you remember that night?
Oh, that was
so horrible. As long as it's not Swiss or tap water, it'll be fine.
Oh, my God.
This whole scene is so funny. But she lives over Twin Anchors. She, I don't want to give too much away, but he's an architect working on the ape house at Lincoln Park Zoo. So you get some great Lincoln Park Zoo shots in there as well. So definitely.
Isn't this some sort of like romance where she's like reincarnation or he's reincarnation or something?
She's got the heart of his dead wife.
Why?
Sorry.
All righty. That's what we got. So now.
Wait.
So that's a little bit of Chicago.
Okay, so I unfortunately don't have my act. Here we go. Okay. Chicago, what? What are we showing now?
You're showing it. You're showing whatever you got. Or some.
Okay. I'm going to remove that and share something else. Share. Whoop. Here we go.
Ooh.
So if you all remember The Fugitive, the beginning is where she gets killed. And throughout it shows where she gets killed. This is the new one, not the David Jansen one, but this is the Harrison Ford one. And let me flip. Here is where you start to really see a lot of the flashbacks look like this, where they're on these walkways. This is the iconic shot right here. So in this movie, again, I think it's Celia Ward.
No, I think it's Anna Archer.
Oh, you're right. Anna Archer. Yeah. So he's murdered for her being killed. This is where they live. It's 336 Wisconsin. The outside of the home looks like, don't get too dizzy with my spinning through that. Sold for $2,925 in 2018. So
I wonder
why. That has one of the best scenes too of the St. Patrick's Day parade, but it was when it was down Dearborn back in the good old days when we actually celebrated St. Patrick's Day on the 17th and everybody took off work.
Remember and Tommy Lee Jones, chasing him.
Yeah. Exactly right. So are those our six? Is that what we're showing? Yeah.
Yeah.
We got them all. Okay. Good. So that's Chicago in film. If you have any other inside stuff, send it to us and we'll put it back up on the air.
Yes. Oh, right. I wanted to come back to you about last week's property. Remember, I was telling you about that house that was such a good price, you know, just under $700,000 list price. And they were asking for best and final. They went under contract that day. And we won't know until closing what it ultimately sells for. But I'm gonna stay on
just how much over list price it's going for.
So it'll be interesting to see what it sells for. Because remember, they were very, very bossy about what they wanted to see in their best and final offers.
Yeah. All right. Now I want to share with you this week's new listing. Mm. 1629 South Prairie.
Cool.
We're just putting it on today. It's not even on the market yet. I just did photography on Friday. This is really, this is in a really great location. It's located between like the south end of Central Station and the Prairie District, you know, with the Clark House at 1800. So this is right in that area, very walkable, very close to train lines, unobstructed view east.
Wow.
This is a two bedroom plus den for $499.
That's
it's
incredible.
Ready to move in, folks.
And there are probably amenities, yes.
Oh, I'm going to show you amenities, girl.
Yeah.
Yes, there are. There's the den. They use it for a dining room.
Is that the den or that's the dining room?
That's the den.
I would use it as a dining room, too. It's cute as can be.
It is. Now, you could use it as an office.
Absolutely.
He's got this built-in Murphy bed with an office. Mm-hmm. See how it pulls down? Isn't that lovely?
So smart.
So queen-size bed or desk, all in one, ready to go.
My guess is
this
that
is the community room.
Could you get the built-in as part of the price?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Yeah. So this is your view north.
Oh.
I love it when you look north to the city. This is the community room.
What's that water? Is that the pool?
Yes.
That's
fitness
a good
room.
Pool.
This has a balcony.
Oh,
there's
yeah.
your pool. Look at that.
That's a big pool.
And you're overlooking Soldier Field. She says that when Beyonce played, she could sit out on her balcony and hear it. It was wonderful. That's the community room again. Isn't that gorgeous?
It's gorgeous.
There's an outdoor terrace.
So pretty.
Outdoor terrace. And that's it. So $499.
Yes.
Love it, right?
I'll let you sell that in like 2 weeks. No problem.
Come on, everybody. Call your friends. Tell them to come look at it.
Sounds great. Well, we'll see that everybody, we're out of time. We'll see everybody next week.
Sounds good. I have no idea what we're talking about. Yeah. We can talk about what you want to talk about, people. Just let us know. Watch us every week, Monday morning, or you can watch the replay and follow us on Facebook, also on YouTube.
And Insta, all those things. Absolutely. Great seeing you, as always, Anne Rossley.
You too, Kyle Harvey. Have a great week.